appreciation, which is great. But in God's great blessing. Okay. So today is a special day. We have dedication of two babies, and we have a baptism. We're going to baptize Xavier. We will do a pool baptism when we can, as soon as we can, but we're going to go ahead and do sprinkling today. So, amen. We get it done whenever I listen. Some people say you can't sprinkle. I get it done whatever way I get it done. Whenever I need to get it done, okay? I believe in sprinkling it, Xavier. We're going to take care of you today, okay? Okay, first of all, we need JT's family up here for the baby dedication. Look, JT, the message today is the issues of life that comes out of us. And isn't she gorgeous?
Aww.
Yes. Oh, yeah, I know you're pretty. I've seen you before. I saw you in the hospital.
Yes.
Yeah, I think we might as well go push this back. Yeah, let's scoot everything back. Sonia, can you just bring the camera up? And you don't have to bring the whole iPad and everything. I mean, the whole tripod. Just lift the camera up and kind of get where you can. Can you see this from here there?
Yes.
Okay, if you got it, that's fine.
Okay.
Because we're going to be over here in the corner.
Okay.
Okay. I am going to need some help. I'm going to need the parents to sign these two after. Yeah, Joanne, you're a great helper here. Let me show you what I'm going to need some help on after the service. Before I hand them these certificates, go ahead and get these out of here. I'm going to need the mother and father to sign this. Let's do it now. We'll chuck them over here. Let's get this taken care of now. Let's put it on the pulpit.
So beautiful.
JT. You get up there. I'll take pictures with you.
Birth, for she has helped start.
Amen.
The family is a divine institution ordained of God in the beginning of time. It's actually sealed, the marriage between a man and woman was sealed by God. Man cannot make it between man or woman because God has already sealed it. The Lord formed the family before he formed the church. And the head of the family has more authority over the family than the church. My children are an heritage of the Lord. Amen. Come on. Fine. And the fruit of the womb is his reward. JT, as you brought your family in, and I covered that this year. Out of the issues of life, that's going to be my sermon today. We bring forth on the earth what is inside of us.
Amen.
And you're bringing forth souls. You're bringing forth souls. And as you bring people in, you're bringing forth souls. Children are a heritage of God and are committed to their parents for care, protection, and training. The Lord charges us to raise our children in the admonition and nurture of the Lord. As believers, we're called to recognize that children belong first and foremost to God. Today we gather in trust and faith to dedicate Chase and Anaya to God. Am I saying that right?
Yes.
Anaya. It is a beautiful name.
Beautiful.
We're told in 1 Samuel 1 that Hannah presented her son Samuel to the Lord. In Luke 2:22, we read that Mary and Joseph brought their baby Jesus to the temple in Jerusalem in order to present him for the Lord. So today you're presenting your children to the Lord. And you call upon that call. Well, you bring them to the Lord. He's gonna remember one day and he's gonna make that call.
Yes.
In the same way, you bring your son, Jace Cash Williams. Hi, Jace. And your daughter, Anaya Rainey.
Rain
Williams. Presenting first themselves, yourselves, and then your children. Accompanying them are Oksana Lemons, J.T. Lemons, his grandparents, and Susan McDonald. And Justin and Cherie, I call your attention to the commands of God recorded in the Holy Scripture. The Lord our God is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. These commandments I give you today, let them be upon your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road and when you lie down and when you get up.
Amen.
Justin and Cherie, as you love God and one another, you will model before your children a wonderful love for God. By coming today before God and his people, do you hereby declare your desire to dedicate yourselves and your children to the Lord? If so, please respond by saying, we do. In raising them in the nurture of the Lord, Jace and Anaya will walk in the abundant life that Christ offers. I gave my testimony yesterday of how God took me as a child and brought me all the way through prayers he answered. And it kept me all those years. Do you promise by God's help and in partnership with the church to provide a Christian home of love and peace to raise them in the truth of our Lord's instruction and discipline, and to encourage them to trust Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior? You say, we do. Alexa, do you hereby declare your desire to help Justin and Cherie fulfill the promise they made by becoming Jace and Anaya's godparent?
Yes.
JT, Oksana, and Susan, as grandparents, do you hereby declare your desire to help Justin and Cherie fulfill the promise they made?
We will. We will.
I ask the church to make a promise as well. Parents need the help and support of the community. You see, we are to encourage them and lift up their arms and love them no matter what they're walking through. Church, do you promise by God's help to be faithful in your callings as members of the body of Christ to help Justin and Cherie to be faithful to God, to help teach and train Anaya and Jace in the ways of the Lord so one day they may trust Jesus Christ as the Savior?
We will.
Okay. Justin, I need, where's Jace?
Right here.
Okay.
He wants me to hold it.
Okay, hand him to Justin. Let him hand him to me. I want the Father to hand me to you. Hope this is not too cold. It's a little cold. Jace Cash Williams, I anoint you with the oil and with the water. As a symbol of the Holy Spirit, under whose protection and guidance we are sealing you, placing the seal of God upon you.
Amen.
And I dedicate you unto God in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We got it. Yes.
Okay. Let me get this. I don't want them getting upset with me, but Jace didn't get upset with me, did he?
No, he didn't.
Daddy, I want you to hold over.
The baby
can. Anaya Renee Williams, Rain Williams. Oh, you cute. You are cute. Yeah, we don't want to be too cold, do we? I anoint you with oil and water as a symbol of the Holy Spirit, under whose protection and guidance we are sealing you today unto God. I dedicate you unto God in the arms of your Father, and may He always take care of you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Now, Justin, I now present a red rose to you. You can go ahead and hand her off. It's, and you may remember, we did this before, but it's the reason you receive a red rose. As a father figure, you are responsible for the spiritual direction of your home. You are the priest of the household. There's nothing of this earth you will be able to take to heaven with you. If you have the greatest success and you make all the money, there's nothing you're going to take to heaven with you.
Oh.
However, if you train these children the way they should go, you can take their precious souls with you.
Amen.
Cherie, I present you with white rose as a symbol of a mother's love. Happy is a woman who has given birth to a baby. Your children will turn to you for comfort and love when they will turn to no one else in the world. Believe me, I know. They're all independent and grown up until the first bad day, and then they call mama for
That's a word right there.
Cherie, live your life for Jesus, and your children will do the same. They're going to have to grow up in a world that's becoming more and more pagan. And how you raise them, they will turn back to the way that they're raised. They will not depart from the Lord if you raise them in the admonition of a nurturing Lord. They will go the way of the world. They will test it out. They will check it out. You know yourselves. But they will return to God. And to Jace, where's Jace? I present to you a pink rose.
He's all in.
Would you hold it for Anaya?
She hold it herself.
Okay. Pink rose is small and pure and spotless. And may the Lord Yes, I am. Let's do it right now.
Yes.
Let's give you a rose right now.
Oh, wow, she got a pretty big one.
She got a big red rose.
She know what's going on. Everybody else getting roses, she don't give one.
I saw that.
She got a pretty big one.
And just as the little pink rose is pure and spotless, may the Lord bless you and keep you separated from all evil, all the days of his life, your life. Third John 4. I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes.
A baptism. Oh, let me give this to you. Justin. Okay. Come on up here. Okay, I need to ask you if you have received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You have. Okay. Let's pray the prayer together. Lord Jesus, I give you my soul. I ask you to forgive me for all unrighteousness. I thank you, Lord, that you're my Savior. And I receive you as my Lord and Savior. Holy Spirit, come and fill me.
Amen.
And Holy Spirit, reveal to me my Lord and Savior, Jesus. Lord, I just place the seal of the Holy Ghost upon us. And Lord, as he has received the Holy Spirit, Lord, I pray that you put him under the keeping power of Lord Jesus Christ all the days of his life. In Jesus' name we pray. And I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Wait, bend down a little bit. We want to get this good. Already we had a good word about families. Yes, well, I'm all about families. marriages together. I'm all about family. And I'm all about church. That's what issues out of me. The name of the message is Issues of Life.
We're going to have another baptism on the way.
Okay, Deborah.
As soon as you can set it up.
Well, come on right now. We got water and everything. Come on, Deborah.
Yes.
Come on, Deborah. Okay, I want you to sit in front of the church. Okay? Have you received Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Okay. And do you... Okay, let's pray this prayer. Lord Jesus, forgive me of my sins. And I ask you today... to cleanse me from all my sins. I receive your blood. I receive you as my Lord. And I receive you as my Savior.
Holy Spirit.
Come and fill me.
Fill
me, Holy Ghost.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, I place the seal of God upon Deborah. In Jesus' name. Now, it's going to be cold. We're going to mess up your hair. Okay, you got to bend over.
Oh, look at that.
Church has covered the earth. Now the Gentiles are becoming more paganism. more like paganism, and the Jews are going to be coming in, except for a remnant.
Yes.
There will be a remnant of Christians.
Yes, we are.
That will be holding on and walking. It's going to have to be a walk of purity.
Yes.
There will have to be a separation.
Yes.
For the world. If we want to walk in the power that God's going to be releasing upon the earth. I'm not saying that we're not coming into a great revival. We will. But according to what he believes, we're coming to the time of the end. Well, we can see it.
Yes.
I mean, look at the paganism in the church.
Yes.
You can't tell it. No one's offended with what's on your televisions. No one is offended with profanity or vulgarity or obscenity. We have generations of people out there that don't know what sin is. They don't know what the Word says. They don't know the Bible, and they don't know God.
That's right.
So we're watching it happen, and we have to be aware of it. Around here, you're going to hear Jesus and the gospel of Jesus Christ. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. What is coming out of you? What is coming out of you? I just said what comes out of me this morning. If you know me, you won't dispute it. Family, church. Family, church.
Yes.
And I encourage other families. Families, church. God made the family before he made the church.
Yes.
Our time and lines on earth have fallen at a time when people are walking away from Jesus as their first love. His will and kingdom is no longer their priority. It's not even, it's not down number 10 on their list of priorities. They're busy with their own lives and fighting. The church is fighting among themselves. We saw it at our conference. Over issues which are not relevant to the present purposes of God.
Amen.
People are fighting over the Holy Ghost. Isn't that stupid?
Yes.
Bible says we're not supposed to say stupid, huh?
Yes.
Why would godly men and women fight over the Holy Ghost? That's what they've been fighting over since 1900. Since the Holy Spirit came in power, they've been fighting over the Holy Ghost. With fighting, our fighting, we see this fighting has become paganism in the government and in churches. Just turn on your television. There it is. Isaiah 55, 6 through 8. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. And let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him and to our God. For he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, says the Lord. So continually he calls the church to come back to him. When we lost the power, when the church lost the power, is when we began to conform to the world. When the world came into the church, and we wanted to keep everybody, we wanted to keep our children from being upset. That was how it started. Our children were getting in the 50s. Our children were picking up the ways of the world. And we wanted our children ministered to. Now, I grew up in the 50s, okay? So the church allowed the world in because the children had begun to take over the families.
Right.
Children had begun to rule the families. We have reached a time when children in a family very often control the family because they're threats that they might do something terrible. Am I preaching good today or what? Parents, God set parents over the family.
Yes.
Every issue in the earth has its answer in the heavens or in the realm of the spirit. Spiritual problems require spiritual solutions. Today, the creative shaking of the heavenlies is bringing changes all around us. We're staying right on Lou Engle's prophecy. He's changing the nations that they will come into the destiny of nations.
Amen.
He is shaking the media, Hollywood, justice system,
Washington,
D.C., and the church. Those who are called my church. Who would you say are those who are called his church? Those who have compromised with the world system. There is no separation. As I told you, I think a couple weeks ago, I don't have time to sing it. I'm too busy doing what God called me to do to be worried about wanting to sin. You know why? Because I'm so happy doing what God called me to do. That I don't have this other stuff on my mind. The kingdom of God is his purpose and the church is his instrument. The church consists of the called, the chosen, and the faithful. Many are called, but few are chosen. And of those who are chosen, very few are faithful. But the church of the living God are the ones that are called, they're chosen, and they are faithful. Who have received Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior through the power of his blood, not our power. Jesus is the wisdom of God, and it is from above. Wisdom is a supernatural force, a gift that God gives our lives. It is supernatural. If you ask God for anything, ask him for wisdom. I did. And he's given me a measure. The issues of men are from beneath, governed by other kinds. Wisdom. So what are the issues in your heart? Are they the issues of the world that you worry about? Are they the issues of what mankind worries about? Or are they the issues of God, which is wisdom from above? James 3:14-17. If you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your hearts, do not boast about it or deny the truth. Okay. If you have envy of anyone, it's a sin. Mm-hmm. If someone has something that you want and you covet it, that's a sin.
Yeah,
if you want something, ask God and he will be glad to give it to you. If you pray, he will be glad to bless you. Now that doesn't mean you're going to get a new motorcycle. Or that a motorcycle's coming or something like that. I'm just teasing with you. I'm not talking about, the Cadillac thing where you pray God gives you a Cadillac, although he did. Such wisdom does not come down from heaven, but is earthly and spiritual of the devil. Envy and selfish ambition. Your selfish ambition of that what you want for yourself will not get you the glory of God.
Amen.
It will cost all of yourself. Mm-hmm. There will be no more self. Mm-hmm. And that's what God ushers his glory through. For where you have envy and selfish ambition, there you find disorder and every evil practice.
Amen.
For the wisdom that comes from heaven is first of all pure. Then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy and good fruit, impartial and sincere. That's the reason when you see the media stirring trouble, purposely and intentionally starting trouble, stirring trouble, and building trouble so that they can have a story. That wisdom is never from above.
That's right.
But they want to be, they really trying to be prophets. They are. They want their word. Oh, I said this and it all came to pass. Okay. They're trying to prophets of Baal. But if it stirs trouble, causes trouble, and trouble follows it, that issue did not come from God.
Yes.
It came from Satan.
Yes.
Whatever causes trouble,
yes,
did not come from God. Because what God brings is peace loving. There are many plans in a man's heart, but it is the Lord's purpose that prevails.
Amen.
1 Corinthians 6:19-20. What know you not, that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which you have of God, and you are not your own? Mm-hmm. For you are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Let all of our speaking and all of our talking bring forth life. Let no corrupt conversation come out of your mouth. We belong to the Lord. Yet many Christians think we still have choices. Okay? God bless my choice. God bless my choice. Their guide is like the manager of a heavenly supermarket where one can shop with leisure and pick and choose. These folks save face by raising the smoke screen of doctrinal issues. That's part of the arguing that's going on in the churches. When you see pastors and preachers start defending what they're doing, okay, they're trying to cover for themselves. You see, truth doesn't need defense. Purity doesn't need defense. It just is. You don't have to defend it. If you're doing something and it's not proper and right before God, you're not going to have to defend yourself. You're not going to have to cover it with, so-and-so's doing it, and everybody on the internet's doing it, and everybody on Facebook's doing it, and all the other kids are doing it.
I'm only human.
I'm only human.
No excuse.
When we start defending what we're doing, we're covering our sin. Who governs us? Is Jesus Christ the Lord, the King, the boss of our lives? Romans 1:23-25 says that men have exchanged the truth for the lie. We have a lying spirit over this nation. A lying spirit is not just a liar. A liar purposes to tell a lie because they want to lie and deceive someone. A lying spirit believes their lie. And you've got to be able to separate this. Men bartered away their souls to wallow in the pottage of what passes away. They made a deal with the devil, relinquishing their birthright of permanent blessings. Every issue raised by men cannot last, while the issue of God cannot die. Mm-hmm. His kingdom will never end. Amen. His government and peace is an endless increase. People want peanuts, popcorn, and candy, not the meat of the word. A quick affair, whether natural or spiritual, in a motel room or before the pulpit, is preferred over a lifelong experience of wedded love. Many would rather enjoy a spiritual one-night stand, I'm talking about church, than a committed relationship to a local fellowship of believers. Then the one-night stand doesn't cost you anything. Acts 8:33 says the Messiah was deprived of justice. Early in our life, we're taught to fight for our rights. But there's a place where you say, just bow down and say, you're right. You're right. Whatever. There are situations wherein we're 100% right, yet still blamed, falsely accused. Our good is sometimes spoken of as evil. I'm a pastor. Every time we've had members, over the years, I can't say I've seen it all because I don't want the devil to throw something at me I haven't seen yet. But when a person gets ready to sin, and they made up their mind that they're going to sin, they will be begin to come against me for something that I've said or done. They will begin to make me the villain, like I have anything to do with it.
Yeah.
I'm just a preacher. All I do is say what God says.
Yes.
God is the one that we are to please, not the preacher.
Amen.
Matter of fact, I don't even care. I love you, but hey, if you're going to go out there and get involved in sin, oh, go ahead. You know? I told you when you came to church that Sunday, you know it was a sin, and you know that when sin enters your body, that you're going to reap the result of sin. You're going to reap what you sow.
Amen.
If you commit adultery, it will bring sickness on your life. The Bible is clear. Well, I am preaching.
Yeah.
We're misrepresented. If you're going to walk with the Lord, people are going to misrepresent you. They're going to malign you. They're going to persecute you for righteousness' sake. You know why they do that? To make themselves look like they're okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Like the master, we must not complain or sin with our mouths. The dead man need not defend himself. If you're dead to your carnal soul and to your own reputation and your own ego and your own vanity of religion and your own vain glory, you don't have to defend yourself.
Amen.
And all these arguments that you see going on in Facebook about people, they're defending their own vain glory and their own ego and their own vanity of religion. Every preacher in his or her immaturity has a point to prove and usually will kill for it. Well, am I right? They'll go for the jugular.
That's true.
Some casualties in the kingdom are due to ignorance and arrogance of the sword of issues, not the sword of the Spirit of God. Moses and Paul were two good preachers. They were great preachers, but they're not just good preachers, they were great. Both had to mature and lay aside the issues of men. Both had to go into the wilderness to lay aside their issues. Paul had to go in the wilderness 4 years. Moses was in there 40 years. And he didn't even get to go in the promised land, but he still had issues.
Yes.
But he still appeared on the Mount of Transfiguration.
Yes.
There are at least over 200 doctrinal issues that preachers, denominations, and congregations disagree on, which are just the issues of men.
That's right.
They're majoring on minors. You ever known someone to major on minors? They make an issue over something that's nothing? Men prefer to preach from the tree of knowledge of good and evil rather than the tree of life. 1 Timothy 1:4. Neither give heed to fables and endless genealogies, which minister questions rather than godly edifying, which is in faith. So too. 1 Timothy 6:3-5. If any man teach otherwise and consent not to wholesome words, even the words of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the doctrine which is according to godliness, he is conceited and understands nothing. A lot of conceit going on out there, people trying to preach and argue. He has an unhealthy interest in controversies and quarrels about words that result in envy, strife, malicious talk, evil suspicions, and constant friction between men of corrupt mind who have been robbed of the truth and who think that godliness is a means. Financial gain. That's a word. Where the church is, back to the church is right now. People going into ministry thinking they're going in for financial gain. God makes you a steward of his money. That means you better put it where God says.
Oh, that's the truth.
Out of the heart are the issues of life. Jesus came out of the bosom of the Father. Jesus is the true issue priestly in nature. In relationship to the Father in heaven, Jesus is the worshiper of the Son of God. In relationship to all men in the earth, he is the intercessor of the Son of Man. The good man brings good things out of the good stored up in him. And the evil man brings evil things out of the evil that's stored up in him. Now that says it all. Whatever is inside of you is what you're going to preach. Whatever is inside of you is what's going to come out of your mouth and will come out of your life.
That's right.
Yes.
That will be the fruit of your life. Jesus Christ issued from God. Out of him issued the church. The church is the issue out of Jesus Christ. Whatever we have in us, I said this yesterday at the club meeting. I was talking about pain, because there was a lot of it in the room. And I said, if I am full of pain, then I'm going to beget pain.
That's right.
Wow.
Well, if I am full of adultery, I'm going to beget adultery. If I'm full of bitterness, I'm going to preach bitterness. If I'm full of a religious spirit, I'm going to get mean.
Okay.
Religious spirits are mean.
Yes.
But if we're full of Jesus, love's going to come out of us.
Yes.
Mercy, goodness. If we're not in alignment with the world, God's going to restore the power back to the church.
Wow.
What are the issues of your life? Has it been, you have been ambitious all your life? I was, till God got a hold of me. No words can adequately describe the worth of the treasure who came from the bosom of the Father. Jesus, the unspeakable gift, is the essence of wealth, the legal covenantal heir of all things in heaven, in earth, and under the earth, and he lives in you. The wealth of the universe is in him, and he wants you to be wealthy.
Yes.
But you have to be able to handle it.
Yes.
He is they can't handle you. You got to be able to handle wealth or whatever wealth you have, but if it handles you, then that becomes your God.
Okay, all right.
You have something special to do that no one else can do. When God was ready to say something good to his planet, you were born. He put destiny in each one of us. But he also put something else there. He put the world. Intentionally and on purpose. Because until you overcome the world, you're not victorious and walking as an overcomer. Today, we have celebrated the birth of two unique and special children. Jace and Anaya. Who have today been called, set apart, and sealed into the glorious kingdom. The Lord brought in double. He brought in Xavier, and he brought in Deborah. JT, the fruit of his ministry, dedication brought in double.
Amen.
Okay, and I prophesy now, that because the Spirit of God did this today, and that double souls came in with one soul, that there shall be a double blessing upon Anaya and upon Jace all the days of their life. First family of the whole earth was Adam and Eve. female created he them.
Amen.
And he sealed it.
Yes.
And the seal cannot be opened by Jesus Christ, except by Jesus Christ. And the devil is trying to open the seal. And out of it is going to come the issues of death. I said the issues of death will come out of the Satan trying to open the seal that God sealed male and female to bring forth the family. Somebody says, Carolyn, you can't preach that.
Preach.
And God bless them. You see, the blessing. The blessing was sealed too.
Yes.
On the godly family that's up under the Lord, the blessing is sealed.
Amen.
And said to them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion.
Yes.
That's the issue out of the sealing that God placed with man and woman to be married in his eyes, to bring forth the family. He also gave them authority over the earth.
Yes.
This is the Great Commission for establishing families.
Yes.
It won't change.
No.
Amen.
And all that comes up that's not under that will bring death. It begins with the book of the generations of him that made the world. In Luke 3:23-28, Luke takes the family of Christ all the way back to Adam. Matthew goes no higher than Abraham. Luke went all the way back to Adam. That was some kind of, only God could have given him. Jesus could only tell him that. His purpose was to show that Christ was the son of Abraham, in whom all the families of the earth are blessed. And that he was the son of David and of the royal family. You want to know about your DNA? It's royal.
Amen. Yes.
Jesus is revealed as one who was born from a sealed lineage. It's reason, one of the reasons why they put it in there. Why they put it in Matthew and why they put it in Luke 3. To tell the whole world the lineage of Jesus Christ was sealed. It went to great trouble. Jesus did, God did, when he put the Jews in exile in Babylon. He kept a pure stream. And only that pure stream were allowed to come back to Jerusalem to build the temple. If the family line had not been kept pure, they stayed in Babylon. Only those who had kept their lineage totally pure were allowed to come back to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple. What a family. You and I have been grafted into this family through the blood of Jesus. And I claim, and today, as we brought these children in, this is no small thing. Those children have been grafted in to this family lineage of the royal house of David and of the promises of Abraham and of the blood of Jesus Christ. See, Jesus is going to come when they make a claim on what's been dedicated to him.
Yes.
Satan's going to come one day and try to make his claim.
Mm-hmm.
And parents, that's when you need to be standing. Standing strong. I claim the promise and blessing that through Jesus, my family is blessed.
Amen.
Your family is blessed.
Amen.
And all the families who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ are blessed.
Amen. Yes.
Not because I say it, but because it was sealed when the Lord set up that marriage should be between a man and a woman, and out of them would come the earth would be filled. That was when the seal was given of the blessing that's on the family.
Yes, amen.
And it's ours. It belongs to us.
Yes.
It's ours to apprehend. Amen. We just got to walk in it.